Hi, welcome to One and All. In this session, in continuation to theorem 8.3, we will go to the next theorem, that is theorem 8.4. The statement is that f be an arithmetical function which is periodic mod k, then there is a uniquely determined arithmetical function g, also periodic mode k, such that f of n is equal to summation n equal to 0 to k minus 1 g of n e raised to 2 pi I m n by k. In fact, g is given by the formula g of n is equal to 1 by k sigma m equal to 0 to k minus 1 f of m e raised to minus 2 pi I m n by k. The proof here, the only difference between the previous theorem and this theorem is that earlier we had instead of fn we had a wn, and instead of gn we have an. So here is a typographic mistake. That here it is fm, not fn. It is fm instead of fn. So please correct that, note that correction. And the only difference between the previous theorem and this theorem is that this f, instead of wm we have fn, and instead of an we have gn. So let us see what happens. Suppose f is an arithmetical function which is periodic mode k, then the proof can be similar to that of the previous one. Here what we can do is, instead of fm we can replace it as wm. In the previous theorem we can replace wn by fm for all m equal to 0 1 2 3 etc k minus 1. Since fm is periodic mode k, we have fm is equal to f of m plus k, that is this fm will repeat after fm after k period. That is after k, that is if fm k plus 1 will be again fm plus 1, like that. So f1, like it will be fm. So fm fm plus k plus 1 will be fm plus 1. So we can see that we apply the previous theorem. Instead of this a0, a1, a2, etc., ak minus n, we can give some suitable scalars which are also periodic, which should also be periodic, because here the function fm is periodic. So we have to correspondingly obtain a functions g which are also periodic. So in that case, by the previous theorem, we can have a function g of m which is replaced by an, and we can extend this definition of gm to all integers m by periodicity mode k. We can see that the result can be obtained by this result. So here fm, we can replace here wn by fm and an by gn. So we will get the result fn is equal to summation n equal to 0 to k minus 1 gn e raised to 2 pi I mn by k. And similarly, in the by the previous theorem, gn can be obtained by summation 1 by k summation m equal to 0 to k minus 1 fm e raised to minus 2 pi I mn by k. Thus, corresponding to every fm, there is uniquely determined arithmetic function gn such that f is related to g by the equations, these equations. So please note that here m equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc., k minus 1. This numbers repeats after k. That is what the speciality of this the function fm is. F is periodic function, g is periodic function. So after this 0, 1, 2, 3, etc., k minus n, the terms again repeats. So again repeats like m is equal to 0, m equal to 1, like that. So this summation can even be replaced by m n mod k, and here also we can replace it as m mod k. So that is, we can have it as a note that if both f and g are periodic mod k, we can write the sums in the theorem 8.4, that is in the previous theorem, as f of n is equal to n summation n mod k g of n e raised to pi I m n by k, and g of n is equal to 1 by k summation m mod k fm e raised to minus 2 pi I m n by k. In each case, the summation can be extended over any complete residue system modulo k. Any complete residue system modulo k, you have already studied about this complete residue system modulo k, that is system which includes at least one member from each residue class of, so a system which contains at least one residue, one element from each residue class modulo k, that system is called a complete residue system. So that, in if we can replace even this the functions by this complete, any members of this complete residue system modulo k. Thus the sum in 3 is called a finite Fourier expansion of f, and g of n defined by 4 are called the Fourier coefficients of f, that I have already told that these are the Fourier series terms in a Fourier series, and this is the terms for this coefficients. To obtain the coefficients gn, we have to use this. Please make a correction that f of n is, this is not f of n, this is f of m. Okay, I hope you have understood the concepts clearly in this session, and thank you very much for your patient listening, and if you have any doubts, you please ask via phone or by comments. Thank you.